In this illustration, we'll discuss a particle in motion with the time-varying position vector. We are given that a particle moving in 2D motion has its position vector varying with the time as r is a t square I cap plus b t to the power 4 j cap. And we are required to find the equation of trajectory of particle and the angle between its velocity and acceleration vector as a function of time. Here, in this situation, we can write the x coordinate of particle's trajectory would be a t square and its y coordinate can be written as b t to the power 4. And from this relation, we can see the value of t square is x by a. We eliminate t between the two coordinates which are given as a function of time, we get the trajectory. So here we can directly get y is equals to b. This is x by a whole square. So we can write y is equals to bx square by a square. This is the result for the equation of trajectory of particle, which we can see clearly this is a parabolic trajectory. And if we wish to find the velocity vector of particle, motion, this can directly be given as v vector is equals to dr by dt. And if we differentiate this vector, we can see this will give us 2at I cap plus 4bt cube j cap. Similarly, we can calculate the acceleration vector of particle as a vector is equals to dv vector by dt. And further differentiating this expression, we are getting 2a I cap plus 12bt square j cap. So, in this situation, if these are velocity and acceleration vector, we can find out the angle between these two vectors as cos theta is equals to v cap dot a cap. Here we can write if theta is angle between v vector and a vector at any time, here we can write the angle between two vectors is given as cos inverse of the dot product of their unit vectors. So your value of theta is cos inverse of v cap dot a cap, which can be written as cos inverse of this will be v vector dot a vector divided by their magnitude va. So if we substitute the values, we'll get the value of theta, which is cos inverse of the whole term. Here we can write if we take the dot product of these two. Here you can see this will give us 4a square t plus this will be 48b square t to power 5. And in denominator, we can write the magnitudes of v vector and a vector, which is magnitude of v vector, we can write as root of this 4a square t square plus the 16b square t to the power 6, and multiplied by we take the magnitude of acceleration vector, which is 4a square plus this 144b square t to the power 4. So this is our final result. If you wish, it can be further simplified, or this is the result. If numerical values of a, b and time is given, we can numerically calculate the angle between velocity vector and acceleration vector of such a particle in its motion.